Hello, everyone. My name is Jimmy Johnson with We're Living as a Vacation. On Facebook, We're Living as a Vacation, as well as we'relivingasavacation.com. And today, we have a special guest, Gail Sartele.
Hello.
She's with Chippingales, right?
Right. Chippingales Carve Signs.
Chippingales Carve Signs. And today we're going to be discussing the behind the scenes of this Where Living is a Vacation sign, the original signs that were in the area. So I figured I need to reach out to Gail and find out who created these awesome looking signs, because when I saw them in person, these signs were at least, I think, 8 feet tall and very creative looking, very thick signs, durable signs, and come to find out, handmade. So I was like, I gotta find out who this author is, who's the one that put the footprint in the area. So so I'd like to introduce Gail Sartele, and could you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay, yeah, like I said, my name is Gail Sartele. I pretty much grew up in the area. My folks moved us out here to this area, to Rochester, when I was 16. Graduated from Rochester High School. And later when we got married, we moved to Lake Orion. We've been here almost 40 years now. And for 30 years, I've been a sign maker. I've always been an artist and always liked wood carving. And so I decided to put the two together and noticed early on, in about early 80s, a few wood signs in the area, like at my veterinarian. Decided maybe I'd give that a try. And gradually the business grew, and I got where I was doing quite a few signs for a lot of people in the area.
Yeah, not many people were doing probably handmade signs at that time. And obviously there probably weren't a lot of sign shops at that time doing large scale signs like what you did here. So I guess questions about this sign in particular, like who approached you to create this sign, and I guess like what is the background behind the sign?
Okay, I was approached by a lady who was the manager at Oxford Bank, Karen Lurch, at the time, and I believe she was president of the Chamber of Commerce at that time, and asked me about doing a sign, so I did some drawings for him, and we went from there.
Well, were there any like designs that kind of hit the cutting room floor of, did you have a favorite, or was this one?
Pretty much this was it. They just told me they wanted a large sign on a stone base, and it was kind of inspired by a sign that was seen up on Highway 2 in the UP for the Hiawatha Forest. And with a little improvisation of it, I came up with that design, and the picture at the top was just to represent the area, the woods, the lakes, and the, you know, our natural environment around here.
Yeah, I saw the lakes. Yeah, I saw the lakes, trees. I'm like, okay, you really captured the essence of Lake Orion, where Living's Vacation. Did the director at the time give you the tagline, "Where Living's a Vacation"? Like,
yeah, there was, I believe, someone in the Chamber of Commerce came up with it, and they asked that to be included on the sign.
Yeah, so it has a lot of history here in Lake Orion with it being a vacation land.
Yeah,
back in the 1900s, and having the amusement park, and this was considered up north for Detroiters. So
yeah, well, back I guess people didn't travel too far. You know,
no.
The roads weren't that great way back, but
no, yeah, they just jump on the Detroit Urban on the train.
Get on Woodward and or the train. There was a train from Lake Orion right down to Detroit too.
Yeah.
So
that made it great for vacationers, and just probably made it really easy to vacation, even though you're only about 40 miles away.
Yeah.
So. But nowadays, you have to go all the way up north.
Yeah.
We're talking Traverse City, UP even. But I definitely recommend, or definitely recommend the UP, especially like Escanaba, and then on US 2. I definitely see that sign every time I drive past.
Yeah, so I wasn't aware of the sign until after I made these signs. But then when I've taken many trips over to Wisconsin, I always take Highway 2.
Yeah.
And I noticed the big signs they have up there on a stone base.
Yeah.
And,
wow.
So
What kind of material did you use to make this sign?
These are all made out of clear heart redwood. And it's very durable, doesn't rot, and can last 50 years or more. And so it was made in two sections because I had to, my husband and I put them up, figured we'll just be the easiest way. They measure 8 foot by 10 foot all together.
Mm-hmm.
And the letters are carved out with a router. I draw a pattern, draw that on the wood, then cut it out with a router. And all the area around the Orion Township part is hand chiseled.
Wow.
And then just exterior paints to finish it off.
Yeah, because I was looking at this up close because I've always seen it just from the roadside. And I can see the detail, especially behind the Orion Township lettering. But yeah, up close I can see, now you're saying it was chiseled, I can feel like how you just chiseled every little piece out. Like,
mm-hmm.
It's amazing. How many hours do you think it
hours-wise, I couldn't say, but average for a sign like that was about 3 to 4 weeks to make one sign.
3 to 4 weeks,
yeah.
Wow.
And altogether, I did 5 signs for the town or the Chamber of Commerce.
5 signs?
Yeah.
Wow, so like the concrete part, like they had somebody
else
do it.
Well, they had a mason person doing the mm-hmm. stonework. And
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and then the redwood. We don't have any redwood around here, though, so how did you get that?
Not anymore. I was very fortunate then, Dillman and Upton Lumber in Rochester.
Yeah.
They were selling redwood at the time.
Oh, okay.
And I continued to use redwood for several years for making signs because it's about the best thing you can get, but eventually the price of it got so high they switched.
Mm-hmm.
And I started making signs out of clear red cedar. Western red cedar,
okay.
Also is good for signage.
Because this really held up, because I've seen it recently and it's still a pretty solid piece.
Yeah, it doesn't rot. No.
Jeez. And you mentioned you had, was there a favorite design that you had outside of this particular one, or was kind of like
pretty much this is it, yeah.
Wow. So how do you feel when you first discovered the signs were removed?
I'm kind of sad and disappointed. I was on my way home one day a few weeks ago, noticed that the sign was missing because I've been anxious and wanting so bad to repaint them.
Yeah.
And, you know, just make them look their best because they have been there quite a few years. But I know things change. People have new ideas and things just, people have different designs they want to try.
But the detail was so great on those, and that's how I found your name. Was like, you must have had your name painted on the back because it said when it was last repainted.
Oh,
I was like,
okay.
Oh, that started doing some sleuthing,
yeah.
Trying to figure out somebody did this locally, and then I saw the name, the Chippingales. I'm like, that is awesome. I love that name.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it was a kind of. It was either going to be Chippaway signs, or then I thought, well, I thought of Chippendale. I thought everybody remembers the Chippendale name. It's fine furniture maker.
Mm-hmm.
And so I just did a little play on words there.
Yeah.
My name's Gail.
Perfect marketing. Perfect. So do you still do any woodworking today? Or
I do. Occasionally I do some wood carving. I go to a few wood carving shows and... you know, there's a few examples I have in the front here, but you can see them. But
so these samples here, are these ones you do shows and sell these at shows, or you kind of do these for?
I did these for myself, but I've sold some of my work in more artistic kind of things. I've done portraits of people's dogs in three dimensional mm-hmm. style, relief style.
Oh, nice.
So it's a good hobby.
Yeah.
All kinds of woodworking. Earlier this year, I even made a banjo. So
cut out the shape and...
Out the whole thing, yes. Frets, strings. Because I have always done woodworking since I was very young.
Yeah.
And I'm also a musician, so...
Oh.
I played the fiddle. And I joined a group called Just Banjos that is mostly banjos, but it's gradually become other instruments, too. So I decided I'm going to try to make a banjo.
Yeah.
So I did, but.
So you have many creative outlets then.
Yeah.
So there's never a dull moment with you. You have something that you can work on.
Oh, yeah. I'm always coming up with ideas.
Well, we were searching online during this process of finding you and the company and the We're Living's Vacation, the signs. We stumbled upon a video on YouTube that was filmed. Joe, maybe you take it away if you can show her.
We're here this afternoon to thank and recognize some work that's been done by a very fine citizen of the Orion community. Joe Gwynn, who has donated graciously the property that we stand on for the sign that stands behind us. Joe and his wife, Mary Kay, have been very, very cooperative with the chamber and in our efforts to put these signs up. And when the idea came to do an addition to the sign to return safely because Orion does care, Joe once again worked with us, and Mary Kay, his wife, once again worked with us and just did a marvelous job. They've landscaped this over the years and made sure that the property looks very nice during the summer. And we want to thank you for your efforts, and we want to present this plaque to you in appreciation for those efforts, Joe.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I have a few words. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to say a few words about some people that made this corner possible to be what it looks like today. First of all, the Oakland County Road Commission. They cleaned up the ditches and put the driveway in and supply gravel. I can't remember the guy's name that I worked with, but they were very cooperative. In Oakland County, Orion Township, Dick White, he supplies the water from the fire hydrant to water the flowers with. Michigan Bell Telephone Company, and their landscaping and the brick that's done there, through the efforts of Marie English and Orion Township Planning Commission, and it's a joint project with everybody involved. We had cooperation from everybody, and I sure appreciate the plaque. And also my wife Mary here, she takes care of the everyday nuts and bolts of having the lawn mowed and the flowers planted and seeing to it that it gets done. Thank you. Thanks again for the plaque. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, I forgot to mention the doctor. The doctor, come forward here. Here's the doctor. He took care of the sign, getting it, the words taken care of, and seeing to it that the sign got built and erected and overseeing the whole thing. He's a terrific man.
Joe, thank you. But the artist responsible for this is just coming. Gail, would you come over, please? This is the artist for the sign. Gail, good to see you. And we want to thank you very, very much.
You're welcome.
I'll turn you back over to the president of the chamber.
Thank you again, and thank you all for coming.
Yeah, so that was a video we found on YouTube from 1995. So you're saying you haven't seen that video before?
Oh,
you were there, obviously.
I was there. I guess I never saw the video, I guess. Because, they weren't that easy to get back then in 1995. I didn't have a cell phone and access to all of that.
Yeah, we'll definitely send you a link to it. That's
pretty cool.
It's a great live dedication that happened and should be remembered.
I'm guessing that must be the one that was at Brown Road in Joslyn.
That's what it looks like, yeah. Just judging by like the cars going by in the road.
Yeah.
By there.
And then,
and then
the road just got changed.
Yeah. Well, I also have a gift for you, you know, being a graphic designer, seeing this sign and, you know, seeing it taken down, and like, this is like a, you know, a memorable occasion because it's, you don't see many unique signs like this. And it's our attempt to recreate the sign. And I wanted to give this to you as a gift that you can remember it by.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, we...
I was so proud to have be able to represent our town. I love Lake Orion, and Yeah, I was sad to see the signs be changed, but I'm glad to had it there all these years. So,
yeah, and this is, I mean...
Well, it's a great way to, as a keepsake. I appreciate that so much.
Yeah,
thank you.
You are welcome. And, you know, being a part of the Orion Historical Society, too, we're going to make these so we can keep that so people would want to hang this up in their living room or office.
Wow.
And with portions of proceeds going to the Historical Society, because this is a historic piece. What you created was history. And even right down to this, this was literally a picture of your sign.
Yeah, this was all my, I dreamed that all up. Lake Orion, our lakes and forests and sailboating, all the things you can do here.
Yeah, truly. Yeah, we're living as a vacation, and we appreciate you, putting your stamp into Lake Orion history with this sign, and we want to make sure that you're remembered by having this.
Oh boy, I appreciate that so much.
Yeah, you are welcome. Thank you so much. And thank you for being a visitor and wanting to do an interview with me, even though I'm new at doing interviews. You did great.
Me too.
And it was a great wealth of knowledge that I didn't know the background of that I'd love to share out there on social media and our website as well, just to say like, hey, there is somebody that created this, and here's the beginnings, and here's why.
Okay.
So
I wonder what they did with the signs after they took them down. You don't know?
Yeah, there's one in Friendship Park.
They did put one over there?
It's stored there for now, and then...
I was just thinking it would be nice to have one over there where they moved the Porritt barn.
Yep. So right now they're not up yet, but there's plans for them to be relocated somewhere else in the city, so we'll definitely keep you updated where they're at. We'll have to get an updated picture. We'll have you come out.
I'm happy to know that they saved at least one of them.
Yep.
Yeah, if they could put it there in the park or something.
Yeah, I mean, they're an important piece of history, so they will be represented here in Orion.
Well, that makes
Orion
me feel
again.
A lot better if they saved somewhere.
Yep, just in a hiatus.
Well, maybe they can give me a call when they want to put it back up.
We'll have to do a rededication.
I'd be glad to repaint it for them.
Yeah.
But,
that's a great idea.
That's great. I love this.
Well, thank you again.
Thanks again, Jim.
Yeah.
I appreciate it so much. Alrighty. That's nice.